Hey guys, I'm Voilin and welcome to No Zero Days November, a month challenge that I gave myself to work on Gozen every single day of this month. And Gozen is our video editor for the people who are new to the channel. My last video was on the 1st of this month and I thought about making daily videos. Starting from day 2, I know it's like this is not going to work. What have I been up to these last 8 days? Yes, we are the 9 today, so what have I been up to? I made a little bit of progress. I went to a insect museum with my family. On that day I wasn't able to do that much. I had a mental breakdown. So I finally started with the ffmpeg stuff, the part of the code that will actually be able to import different video files like mp4.mov and all those fancy things, also the audio stuff. How can I import those inside of the editor? Yeah, nothing was working and I didn't know why. And it has taken me quite a lot of time. Yesterday I was finally able to generate a video. This is the folder test room from the Gozen project. Here I kind of test new things before. It's called test room. Here I kind of test every little thing. But we also have the render server. In the render server, I basically created this Python script some time ago, a couple of months ago, and I used this to try and make the C++ code. This took some time. And I'll go into more detail of how it actually works. I won't go over the add audio part. I have not been able to test that part out. Normally it should work, but as most things, normally it should work equals to there are probably a lot of bugs and probably my system will crash again. Also, the editing in this video will be quite quick because I just want to do a quick summary. I don't have the amount of time needed if I want to finish the ffmpeg stuff by the end of this month, because I still have a lot of work left. So yeah, I made a pipe renderer. So I use image to pipe, and yeah, that's basically it's not a named pipe because it's not an actual file, but it also works. But first up, you're probably wondering what kind of video would I have rendered first with this entire system that I've made. Here it is. It's a long one. And it's done. So how did I do this? How did I achieve this? First up, let's go to the test room part. So I got a variable stop and I got a variable called frames. The previous methods using this render server in Python, it required on the animation player. Because I was using the animation player, there was some delay and the rendering did not go very quick somehow. However, with this new system that I made in C++, somehow it works a lot faster. The overall generating of frames goes faster because I'm not using the animation player again anymore. And the overall speed in which the file itself is getting compiled, I have no idea how to call it, created, also takes a lot less time. So basically what I can do with this is I can go to my renderers and delete this because it's no longer needed. And I also don't, sorry for the people who want the file of the moving cube, it's gone. So yeah, the way that the video editor will work is with a timeline and every single frame will be its own entry inside of a dictionary or anything. We have this whole entire list of frames. I did not type this out myself, I just used a program that created this list. Looking back at it now, I should have just created that list on startup, but hey, it works. And then on button press, because if you start this project, we have this little screen and the start. We open a new Gozen pipe renderer and we set it up. The values that it takes right now is the location of where you want the video to end up in and the frames per second. And then we go through all the frames. And yes, Gozen is using the 4.2 beta, I think. So we can use this. Like, actually giving the frame a type. And then we just move the position of the purple block inside the subviewports according to the current frame data. And yeah, frame data is basically just the position, the vector to integer. Then we await the rendering server frame post through and draw, so we actually know that the frame is loaded before we take a screenshot of it. And we send it to the pipe renderer with the function addFrame. Oh, whoops. And after that, we finish the video. Don't look at this. I've also, like, it's the 9th day. My kids and my wife are gone on a trip, on a small little day trip, together with a friend of them. So I have a lot of time right now. So I've been hard at work, changing the entire project. And if you look at the amount of changes that I've done so far, yeah, that's kind of a lot. So yeah, we finished the video, so yeah, we don't need to look at that. So this is basically all the code that is required to make this work. And let's go over to the GD extension, which I made in its own repo. So this is the repo that I'm using so far. Why is there Python? That's probably scons. Okay, so 3 stars so far, because then it's at 61 stars, so yay. A lot of this still has to change. I also changed it today to the MIT license, so people can more easily use it inside of their own projects. It's the same license as Godot, if I'm not wrong. So if you want to use the ffmpeg stuff in your own projects, you can hope that this works soon or help it contributing. Yeah, but I'm not really certain how many people actually know how to work with ffmpeg, and yeah. My main issue so far with ffmpeg stuff is that all the information right now is kind of outdated. We're at ffmpeg 4.0 and a lot of functions got deprecated. But yeah, I'm slowly working my way up. This Gozen pipe renderer does not use the library, but uses the command line. Here we have our setup function, output, and we need the frame rate. Then we create the command. To override up, I put information comments through all the whole thing, so you can just read through it, read through this entire thing yourself. Then we print the command line. I don't actually need this anymore, so let's do this. And then we open the pipe with a popen. Process open, I think that's what it stands for. We basically don't really need this function. This is also just debugging, so let's also remove that. And then add frame. How do we add the frame? So we require a image. If you use, that's something that I've learned as well. If you use Godot specific classes like image, you will need to use references. And then you need to use this instead of a dot. This took me 1 hour, 2 hours to figure out. And another thing is, I was first doing get data. If you do it like this with get data, like, you're still getting the image data, but it's not the kind of data that the ffmpeg pipe wants. The total amount of bytes that I got for a 440 by 280 picture was over 1 million. The way that you would create the amount of size that has to be written is you have the width, you have the height, and the amount of, like, every pixel exists out of RGB. 3 integers about the red value, green value, red, green, blue, yeah, red, green, blue. So you have the width times the height times 3. If you have the alpha, like if something is transparent or not, then they're 4. But yeah, there was no way that one image was like 1 million bytes. So yeah, something was going wrong there, and after some testing and looking at my previous codes of the render in Python, I saw that I was using .jp, save jpd, jp, png to buffer or jpg to buffer. I decided to use webp because I found that the quality is some, like, the amount of size that it takes is lower to, like, send in bytes, which can speed up the process because there's less processing work that ffmpeg needs to do. If I'm wrong about that, please let me know in the comments. I'm still learning a lot about GD extensions, ffmpeg, and handling bytes instead of just normal pictures. And yeah, we basically write the frame data through the pointer because we cannot, like, it's a packed byte array. And we need a buffer. And if you go to a find definition, so this is the packed byte array class. We have all these things, but this is not a buffer. But if you go over here, PTR, the pointer, that pointer points towards the buffer, because the packed byte array is basically kind of like a buffer. This did not work, so I had to use PTRW. I got this advice from a person in the chat.godot, Godot, and the Godot engine also has like a chat thing, kind of similar to Discord, not really Discord. And somebody gave me the advice of using this one instead. I'm not 100% certain what the difference is between these two, but it works. So yeah, back to the function. So we write, these are the bytes that we want to write. Then we have one because we want to send one byte at a time. And then the frame size is basically, the frame data.size is how big is the amount of data that needs to be sent to that pipe. And then we have the pipe process itself. And then we flush to make certain that all the data is gone. This is something I'm not certain if we need it or not. And also when frame data is too big in bytes, somehow it stops working. So I'm not certain if this method will work for 4K or 8K. Maybe we'll just have to split the amount of data and send each packet separately. So that's the problem for later, and that will probably not be an issue the moment that I have the ffmpeg stuff working through the library itself. I know this is getting very complicated for people who are not very up to date with how programming works. Believe me, I've gotten a lot of headaches as well. And then we finish the video, and basically what we do is we close the file. We close the pipe. Because the pipe is closed, no more new data will be sent. Ffmpeg knows, like, ah, we got close, let's handle all the data that we still have left in memory, and let's push out the video and we're done. That's basically how everything works, and just a quick sneak peek at how the add audio works. It's very similar, we run a command and we only send one file of audio, so we need to put the audio into the correct length and with all pieces of audio on the correct position, because we also have shortest enabled. That way, if your audio is longer than the video itself, the audio will automatically be cut to the end of the video. This could cause one problem because this takes the shortest stream. So basically, a video file is a container of different streams. We have the audio stream, subtitle stream, data stream. All of these things are like data things. They all have their own codec as well. But if the video file will be, the video stream will be shorter than the audio file, and the audio stream, that one will be cut. If the audio stream is shorter than the video file will be cut. So this is one big issue that this whole solution has. It's something I should work on. I'm not certain how yet. I'll leave it for later. And what I'm trying to do right now is I have my test room and this test, and I also have my importer that I'm working on. I have a lot of things that I'm working on right now. Today has been a very productive day so far. If you want to stay up to date with all the progress, go to the Discord server. Join the server, click the flag so you can actually join in the server. A lot of people stay on the welcome screen for some reason. Like, there's actually like things behind the welcome screen, so please join the Discord server. Also, a big thank you to all the people who have been sponsoring me on Ko-hi. All donations through Ko-fi are very much appreciated and really help me to make this whole thing, like, to keep this whole thing going. Because I'm a stay-at-home dad, I don't have any other income except for YouTube and Ko-fi and also itch.io, but that one is more complicated. So yeah, I know this video is kind of short and that I'm talking quite fast is because I don't have much time before my wife and kid gets back. I quickly wanted to make the summary so people are still up to date and they still realize, like, ah, he's still going strong with No Zero Days November. For future videos about No Zero Days November, I have no idea how I'm going to do this. Maybe I'll just make a video every time when I have like a big update, like today, that I can finally render out videos in Gozen. I still don't have a timeline, so yeah, I still have to do everything manually if I want to actually render out videos, but the render system is working, at least a very temporary version. Yeah, so for the next couple of days, like, I made a poll on the Discord server asking what should I work on next? Audio, the timeline, ffmpeg, or any other suggestions. They like to see me suffer, so they took the ffmpeg stuff. The thing that has been causing me so much headaches, so much time loss in the past couple of days, but it is probably the most important part about this whole video editing video editor. So I should really make this work as soon as possible. So thank you all for watching, and I'll try to make my next couple of videos a little bit better and not as quick updates like this one. So yeah, thanks for watching. See you later. Go to my Ko-fi page, support me, or join the Discord server. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.